There are multiple analyst jobs. We have data analyst, marketing analyst, business analyst, and more. But they have many similarities. A data analyst makes around $75,000 per year, a business analyst around $80,000 per year, and a marketing analyst $70,000 per year. The salaries, of course, increase as you get more senior and you can work from home. And while a degree is helpful, you don't need one to get a job. Today, we'll get deeper into the marketing analyst job, which is a less known but incredibly good career in analytics because it's often easier to become a marketing analyst than the other two, and it's a great place to start for beginners. A marketing analyst is basically a data analyst focused on the specific marketing aspects. There is a lot of competition for data analyst jobs right now, so this could be a great opportunity for you to avoid the competition while still getting your first job and experience in analytics. There are different ways to become a marketing analyst, but in this video, I'll cover the Meta Marketing Analytics professional certificate on Coursera, which I believe could be the best way for beginners to get started. Let's find out together. This could be a completely untapped opportunity because very few people have completed this course compared to other courses like the Google Data Analytics certificate, so this course could actually make you stand out. But this is not going to last forever. Let's start with a quick summary of the course and then we'll get into all the details, and it's important that you know this stuff before you get started or you'll waste a ton of time doing the wrong things without getting a job. And if you're thinking about taking another analytics course, then well, this one might be better for you. I'm going to give you everything you need to know in this video and make it super clear in just a few minutes. Starting out with the basics, this program includes a bunch of different courses together and you get a final certificate at the end. It's for beginners, so you don't need any experience, but if you already know some of the material, then refreshing your knowledge and building on top is always a good idea, so you're not wasting your time at all. It is a pretty short course with only 2 months at 10 hours per week, but I would say that most people can complete it much faster. It's included in the Coursera Plus subscription, but they also allow you to audit the course for free as usual. The skills you'll gain are marketing strategy, data analysis, marketing mix optimization, statistics for marketing, and evaluating how your ads are performing by looking at the data and analyzing it. That is probably the first difference when we compare it to data analytics courses. This is data analytics, but it's specifically for marketing, and I can't stress this enough. You are learning a certain part of analytics where the goal is to improve the marketing of the company by understanding the data. For example, in the real world, it could be, is this ad that we're running for Coca-Cola working? What metrics should we look at? Should we do things differently? These are all questions a marketing analyst could work with. Of course, a data analyst could marketing analysts get paid really well, but the jobs are fewer than data analysts, so keep that in mind that this role is more specialized, so you're not really competing with as many people though, which I think is a great advantage over a data analyst position. Now, let's get into the courses and some of the tools that you're going to work with. Course one is about, well, surprise, marketing analytics and kind of introducing you to the field. Course two introduces you to data analytics itself, which is the broader field. And as you can see, they are connected. You will work in spreadsheets and SQL and in Tableau already in course two. And these tools are some of the most in demand for both marketing analysts, but also for data analysts if you want to work in that field as well. The next course in the series is called Statistics for Marketing. And then we have Data Analytics Methods for Marketing. Course five is about marketing analytics with Meta, which is basically working with Meta's analytics platform. This is Meta's version of the Google Analytics platform, and many things you'll learn will, of course, transfer over and be applicable to any platform. Course 6 is slightly different. Here, they're going to help you prepare for the certification exam. If you decide to take this one too, you're going to do a final exam and receive an analyst certification from Meta, which I think is pretty cool. As you can quickly tell, this course has a lot of data analytics aspects because that's what you're doing, just for marketing specifically. So if you want to become a data analyst, this course could still be for you, but I'm going to talk more about this in the end of the video. And in my opinion, it's also kind of cool to be able to explore this part of the analytics world to see if that's something that you want to work with in the future, because you don't really have to work as a data analyst. There are a lot of other jobs in analytics as well. Now, let's talk about the pros and cons. And I think it's a great course from a marketing analytics standpoint. They have fantastic reviews, although it's not really a super popular course because most people tend to focus on the data analytics courses instead when they're a beginner. Now, I really like that they teach you some of the data analytics basics while also focusing on marketing analytics. The course kind of combines data analytics and marketing, which is exactly what marketing analytics is. It is also super affordable, and the certification exam is just a bonus which you get prepared for right away, and I think that's just amazing. Having an official certification is going to be really helpful when looking for jobs. I do recommend this course, I think that's pretty clear, but I don't recommend it for everyone. And I think if you're the wrong person taking this course, you're not really going to get the results you want from it. First, it's probably not the best option for an aspiring data analyst, because you would be better off just learning from a data analytics course without going into all the marketing analytics. If you're more into that, I'll leave a link to my data analyst roadmap in the description, which I think you'll find more helpful. And it's kind of a better idea to follow a data analyst roadmap if you're just an aspiring data analyst. But if you're kind of open to different positions in the analytics world and you're interested in exploring marketing analytics, this is a great course. So it just depends on who you are. I personally really like marketing analytics. I have experience working with ads, seeing how a campaign is doing and optimizing things. And marketing is really cool. You can leverage data a lot to get the best results. And companies really need this. So it's a future-proof field for sure. Now about the course, one downside is that it doesn't go into depth about all the concepts because it is a beginner course and it's pretty short, but that's fine. But if you expect to get a job right away, I would maybe take a step back. It is certainly going to be helpful, but you'll need some more practice, maybe a portfolio, some other things, and keep working on it. My conclusion is that it's not for everyone, but I think it's worth giving it a try if you're interested. It can help you either become a marketing analyst for good or later become a data analyst. You can try the course for free and see if it works for you. We miss all the shots we don't take, so check the link in the description and I'll see you in the next video. Have an amazing week, guys.